guys, it's Nikki from Still Moments Nursery. I've had a number of requests asking me what colour paints I use when painting the lips on my reborn dolls, so I'm going to show you that now. I've already painted one layer of paint on this doll kit. So you can see it's just a very fine layer, so it's very faint. It hasn't got a really bright colour to it, so I'm now going to add my second layer. So this particular doll kit is a Alexa by Audrey Stoke, so she's a gorgeous doll kit, and she's a little custom order as well, so I'm trying to get her finished so I can start on her hair. So what I'm going to do, or what I've done first, is I've actually, that first layer was actually done with the burgundy. So what I did is I just thinned it down with a little bit of water, and I put in a little bit of my matte lac to make it stick to the vinyl, and just very finely painted on using the fine liner brush. So I'm going to do basically the exact same technique and thickness of the paint, so you can see how thick the paint's actually going to be when actually applying it to the doll kit. So what I'll do first, and this one I'm actually going to use Aubergine, which is a slightly darker colour to the burgundy, as you can sort of see. So it's going to add just a sort of, you know, a little bit of a more highlight to the lips. So you just want a little bit of water, so just a couple of drops in there, and you can add more, you know, if you need it. And then you just want to add in just a small amount of your Aubergine. So I'll just get a little bit sort of to start with and just mix it into the water. And you're wanting a sort of a fairly thick colour and consistency. So that's a little bit too thin and watery, so I'm going to add a little bit more in. And it's going to get a lot thicker too once you've added the matte lac in, so just sort of keep that in mind. So I'm going to not add in any more paint because I'm quite happy with the way it's sticking to my palette up here. So I'm going to rinse off my brush because I don't want to put any paint into the matte lac. And again, always remember to put your lids back on your air dry paints because they will dry out. And then with the matte lac, I'm going to put in about the same amount of the paint. So just a heap on my brush. And as you can see, that's got a lot thicker, so it's sort of, it's not running down to the base of the tray as fast, so that's how I can tell that it's thick enough. So what I do is I'll just sort of, I like to actually try and make it stick at the top of the palette, and that way you're getting a lot more paint pigment compared to water. So I just try and sort of do that as I'm painting, and I just find it helps sort of the paint stick to the vinyl a little bit easier. Let's rinse off my mixing brush because I don't need that anymore. And I'm going to grab a fine liner. I've got these available on the website if anybody's looking for a nice fine liner to paint the lips. Basically, I use this to paint all of the lips, the eyes, sort of inside the nose, and any other finer details. So I'm just going to gather my paint of what is remaining at the top of the paint tray. And then just sort of, you know, dab it off a little bit, because you don't know if the colour's going to be too dark, so you don't want to add a whole heap of paint and then have to try and to remove it. And then what I'll sort of do is just sort of go from the inside, and then I'll just sort of work my way and paint out towards the outside. And that way, if it is too dark, it's going to help to darken the inside of the mouth. So that way, it's going to help to give depth. You just want to keep sort of bringing out the paint from the inside out, and then just wanting to smooth off around your lip line, and then again just sort of back in. You're just sort of wanting to blend in that paint, and as you can see, it's a lot darker compared to the original paint that I, or the first layer of paint. So each layer that you do paint, it's going to get darker, so you can get your different shades and sort of highlights in the lips. And you don't want a sharp edge as well on that lip. You want to sort of blend it in. So just try and bring those lines. You can sort of work from inside to outside. And you can basically just create your, you know, your lip sort of how you think it would look. And try to keep sort of the inside as well a lot darker. And that way it's going to give the mouth a lot more depth. Again, I'm just going to gather. I'm not getting the paint from down in the well. I'm still using the paint that's still running down on the paint tray. And I'm just going to do exactly the same to the bottom lip. Sort of make sure you get a lot of paint in that mouth area as well, because you want that as dark as possible. And just sort of bring your paint around and sort of create that little bottom lip. You can go back onto the inside and just blend out that line. And then once you're happy, just leave that to dry. So I'm going to leave that, and then I'm going to apply probably another couple of layers of the aubergine. I'll probably mix in maybe a little bit of red just to sort of darken it up a little bit, and then I'm going to darken inside the back of the mouth sort of with a nice deep dark colour. But that's how I would do my second layer of the lips. And then sort of, you know, over time as you're getting the darker colours, you can sort of put in the little lip lines. So as you can sort of see, she's got little lip lines, so you can highlight those just the same you would as creases. And, you know, darken the nostrils as well, because they need to be darkened. But that's how I do my second layer, using the air dry paint. So the first layer I did it with the burgundy paint. So a very thin layer. So again, you know, sort of the same mix. You can see how thick it is. So I did exactly the same with the burgundy for my first coat. And this coat that you just seen was using the aubergine. So both paints again need to be mixed with a matte lac, so make sure you have your matte lac handy. But yeah guys, that's how I do my second layer, using the aubergine and the matte varnish or the matte lac. So anyway guys, I hope you thought it was helpful, and this little one should be finished soon, so you should be able to see hair on her. But yeah guys, thanks for watching. Hope you thought it was helpful. And yeah, thanks guys for watching. Bye!